Hi, Michel.
Hi.
I thought you didn't like computers. Now I see you have one.
Huh?
At least in the late 1970s, you painted a pretty dark picture of information technology, didn't you? The computer as a kind of torture instrument.
Oh, you mean the discussion back at the Schizo-Culture event in New York?
Exactly. 1978. Your answer to what Ronald D. Lange had stated.
Lange had said something about the self-mechanization of humans. And I remembered what I had heard about Brazil, where techniques of torture had been developed and perfected to a considerable degree with the help of US technicians. Now, one of the characteristics of the new techniques of torture is this: the person who does the torturing is not the same as the one who poses the questions. Someone sits in one room with just a computer in front of him, and on the basis of the computer determines what questions he should put to the victim. He then writes the question down and transmits it to another person, his subordinate, who applies the torture in another room until the answer is obtained. Once he gets an answer, it is fed back into the computer to verify whether it is consistent with the information already obtained.
Sounds like a cynical version of the Turing test, but here it is not used to convince you of the life of the machine, but rather of the opposite.
But that's really not all I said about computers and information technology.
What else did you say?
Well, as you recall, I've been in California a lot since the mid-1970s, so I witnessed the emergence and evolution of the Silicon Valley. That's why it's no coincidence when I compare the techniques of the self, for example, keeping a diary, in their importance with the advent of the personal computer. In antiquity, the new technology of the notebook was as disrupting as the introduction of the computer into private life today.
But you yourself never used a computer, did you?
You mean at home? No, that was just starting then. But ultimately, I've always been interested in information technology, at least since the 1950s.
Since the 1950s? That seems a bit early.
I can even tell you the exact date. 1957, when I wrote some kind of psychological review article in which I explicitly refer to the statistical theory of information and to cyberneticians like Norbert Wiener and Gray Walter.
Okay, I see.
And a few years later, I speculated on the question of whether the dialogue between doctor and patient might not be rethought in the terms of the analysis of language or of information processing.
Cybernetics was very fashionable in France in the 1950s and 1960s. People like Jacques Lacan, Roland Barthes, and Claude Levi-Strauss were pretty much inspired by cybernetic thought. But let's be honest, most of this was about computers.
Maybe not in Lacan and Levi-Strauss, but in historiography it was. It actually started in the 1950s, when historians like David Hilary and Leroy Ladurie relied on computers to evaluate administrative tables in the archives. And more precisely, they relied on punched cards onto which they transferred the numbers they were confronted with.
But that has nothing to do with the archive or archaeology as you understood it.
To the contrary, it's exactly what I was interested in. I recommend you reread the beginning of the Archaeology of Knowledge, where I talk about the importance of, and I quote, the building up of coherent and homogeneous corpora of documents, and where I list the following methods. I quote again, the quantitative treatment of data, the breaking down of the material according to a number of assignable features whose correlations are then studied, interpretative decipherment, analysis of frequency and distribution.
Sounds almost like what today is called digital humanities.
That's precisely what I'm trying to figure out. As is well known, I don't like the humanities, but with the increasing use of computers, something very interesting seems to be happening in this field.
Seems?
I'm trying to find that out right now, but the search engine doesn't offer me any reasonable results.
So maybe it is some kind of torture instrument after all?